Then what we're looking for is, because carbohydrates are so important, a diabetic needs to have about 6 to 8 small meals per day. So in our plan, we're going to have six meals per day, with the obvious being that breakfast, lunch, and dinner would be the bigger ones, but you're going to have snacks, and we need to try to even out our carbohydrate intake throughout the whole day. You don't want to, as a diabetic, you wouldn't want to eat a lot of carbohydrate food at lunch, because that puts a big push on your system. You have a lot of sugar going into your blood system at once, and so that's going to mess up your whole blood glucose regulation. So we need to try to even that out as much as we can throughout the whole day. So you need to spread the carbohydrates, and I'm going to show you have actually boxes that you can type the numbers in and do that. And then the same with the meat choices. You're going to have to fill in the meat choices and kind of even those out through the day. And the same with the fat choices. So what you'd be looking at is, here's your blank food plan, and you'll notice that the boxes are next to the carbohydrates. You're going to fill those in with numbers, and then you'll see the meat and fat, and you're actually going to put the numbers on the lines because there's no boxes. So you just put your choices on the lines, and then after that, you're going to fill in what foods you chose to meet your choices. So the first thing you would do is go through the carbohydrates and determine and put numbers in there. And I think I've done this with the next slide, and you can see what I've done is that I've chosen that, depending on how many choices I have, I may have 22 choices of carbohydrates. Well, I've decided that I'm going to have 4 of those choices for breakfast, 2 for a snack in the morning, and 4 for lunch. And then I'd have to put some more for a snack for afternoon, and then dinner, and then a snack before. So I'm going to have 6 small meals, basically, of carbohydrate intake. And then you have your time, and you have your grams, and so forth. So the next thing I'd want to do is determine what foods. Well, you're going to see on your sheet that you're going to be given some carbohydrate choices, and basically what they are is they give you some foods, they give you the serving amount, and they tell you how many choices they are going to be. So I kind of blew this up, but if you look at this under the grains, what you'll notice is that if you had a waffle that basically had a 4-inch square, if you had one waffle, that's equal to one carbohydrate choice. And then if we had syrup with that, we'd notice that 1 tablespoon is one choice. Then if we wanted to have some juice with that, we'd notice that orange juice, about 1/2 cup or so, is equal to one choice. So if I had 4 choices for my breakfast, what you'd notice is I'm going to have 2 waffles, so I'm going to have 1 tablespoon of syrup and 1/2 cup of orange juice, and so that is going to give me my 4 carbohydrate choices for breakfast. And then you notice I had a banana for snack, and that's a choice, and so forth. And so what I wanted to also indicate that if you like, for a lunch or dinner, if you choose vegetables, a serving size for vegetables is 1/2 cup per choice, and what you'll notice is that 3 servings equals one choice. If you go back, and I forgot to kind of indicate that, what you'll notice is, if you look under the 2 sentences under carbohydrate choices, you'll say a carbohydrate choice is a serving of food that has about 15 grams of carbs. That's why we divided the carbohydrates by 15. So if you go up here and you notice the vegetables are only 5 grams, so each serving has about 5 grams, then obviously 3 servings equals 15, so you can have 3 1/2 cup servings of vegetables, and that would equal to 1 carbohydrate choice. So what I did for lunch is I had 1 1/2 cups of broccoli, and so that's going to give choices. And you'll notice under the carbohydrates, I had 2 slices of bread, so that's 2 choices. I had 1 apple, that's a 3rd choice. And then I had 1 1/2 cups of broccoli, that's my 4th choice to make my 4 carbohydrate choices. So I hope you get the understanding for carbohydrates. The next thing would be for meats and meat substitutes. And what you'll notice is, if you remember, we divided our meats, our protein, by 7, and because each ounce is equal to 7 grams. So 7 grams is equal to one choice, or 1 ounce of meat is equal to one choice. But also included, I've kind of highlighted that, is that we also need to add fat. What they're going to make the assumption that each choice of meat also has 5 grams of fat. So when you eat meat, you're going to have to document both protein or meat and fat choices. But if you look at that first column, those first two columns above meat substitutes, what that's saying is if you add 1 ounce of ham, that's going to equal one choice, basically, of meat and one choice of fat, because if you remember, 5 grams of fat is equal to one choice. So you'd have one choice of meat and one choice of fat, kind of thing. And if you meet a meat substitute, it basically gives you a serving size of what would represent a choice. And so what I did, I said I had 2 ounces of ham because I made for breakfast, I wanted two choices. And you see the two choices in parentheses. So I had 2 ounces of ham, so that's two choices of protein or meat. But also, the 2 ounces of ham is going to be two fat choices. And I have 4 total for breakfast, so I added some butter that I can put on my waffles. All right. And so that's going to basically fulfill my breakfast plan there. And then you'll notice on the lunch, I had 3 ounces of turkey, so that's 3 in parentheses meat choices, but also 3 fat choices. So you kind of indicate both of those. Fats, again, each serving has 5 grams, so again, that's why we divided our gram amounts by 5, and that just gives you the serving sizes that are equal to that. But again, you're going to include your ham. And so on breakfast, we had 4 fat choices. Well, each teaspoon of butter is one choice. We had 2 teaspoons of butter and we had 2 ounces of ham. So that gives us our 4 fat choices. So you're going to fill out that whole sheet and fill in the blanks. Again, you cannot, you look at my evening snack time and you notice that the carbohydrate section is blank. You cannot do that. You have to have every one of them filled in because you have to spread out those carbohydrates throughout the whole days. Not so critical on meat and fat. I mean, it's better that way, but it's very critical that you fill out each individual box for the carbohydrates and even them out so that when you add those 6 boxes together, they equal your DRI or recommended choices. Once you're finished with that, you can push save the document and you can save it where you want to. And so you have to save it where you can remember it. And then what you're going to do is go into module 9 and you'll see the assignment counting upload. We have just gone through and I just showed you the instructions. So go to the upload and you'll choose that. And then what you're going to do is browse and you're going to find both the sheet for you determine choices. Remember the either the Word document or the Excel document. And you're going to upload that file. Then you would click browse again and find the My Food Plan, and you would click the upload on that. And then those would upload those assignments, and I would be able to check those. So I hope that helps in filling out your food plan. And what it also does, I hope, is that it will give you an empathy for someone who has diabetes and has to think about choices every day, and that they need to spread their meals out. They can't go out to a big dinner very often. I mean, you can get away with it once in a while, but you really have to watch your carbohydrate choices. So if you could get that plan filled out and upload it for me, then I can get it graded and we can go from there.